Hello, it's Sara. And look what I have. This is clay. I am putting it through my pasta machine at a number 8. It's about a block and a half or a quarter of, what is this called? Wisteria? Yeah, wisteria. And I am going to put it on a votive. I am going to attempt to do, I'm just trying to let gravity, yes, I did it, okay. So I should have enough here to cover this. And you want to smooth it around and get out your air bubbles as best you can as you go. So let gravity kind of do its thing. I'm going to cut the bottom off and the top off, and I'll add the bottom separately. So let me, this is really soft. It's so warm here today. It's so warm in South Jersey. So I'm just going to cut a straight line and keep working. Oop, there's a big bubble right here. Get that out. Keep working it. Oop, is that still a bubble? Around. I mean, you're gonna get them if you really. And that's why you just have to. It's so sticky though, this clay. But try and work it around. I made a votive yesterday, and I'm gonna show you. I was just in clay mode here. I want to do this, and then I'll go over. Oh man, look, it's a little. I'm just pulling it so that I can cover the bottom, okay. And then once you get it to meet, oops, see, there's like some bubbles. The other end right here, you just cut it. And I like to cut it over the line, so on the other side. And then your two pieces of clay should match up really well. So just peel this back and remove that little strip, and then it should fit right into place. Try and get those air bubbles as you go. And it should, air bubbles. They're my nemesis. This clay is so soft though. And it's a Primo clay. I bought Primo. Primo is a bit stiffer. It's Sculpey Primo. There's Sculpey 3, I think it is, and Sculpey Primo, and those are the two I generally use. But there's a lot of clays on the market, but this works for me. It's craft clay. I don't sculpt. I just play. Oops, I am so rough. So try not to gouge it as you connect, but I just use my finger and blend the seam, and then I'm going to use my blade again to cut off this excess, and I just go right along the edge of the votive, the lip I should say, and comes out pretty. See, there's a bubble. So sometimes you can push it out at the top. If not, you just have to put a hole. So whatever dings and dents I got in here, they're not going to show for the most part. I'm going to do the same thing on the bottom. Trim at the edge. And just push it over the lip a little bit. And then we'll put a bottom on here too. All right, let me set this down, and I'll show you what I'm going to be doing today. So that wasn't that hard. Now, I didn't use any adhesive. I think on glass, this clay sticks just fine. And I've done this before. I have other, probably other tutorials. I'm not sure. I haven't looked lately. Well, this one's black. Let me show you this one. When I took the class by Chris Capono, she's Mandarin Moon, we did this, and I cut out areas, and I mean, I kind of like that look. I'm not going to do it today. I'm going to change it up. I may do a little background stamping. I didn't do any on the piece I did yesterday. This is what I did yesterday. Let me just move this so I don't dent it. Really very inspired by all the boho. Now, boho, bohemian, right? And I think it can, you can go either way. I feel like what I get inspired by is all the color. So it's kind of like mod or the 60s flower power type stuff, right? But it's fringe and feathers and lace. So if you did, what would it be, shabby chic boho, you know, it would be lace and dream catchers and stuff like that. So, but for me, like I said, it's about the color. And yesterday I did this one, and I just played with things that I had in my stash. This is all done with cookie cutters, these shapes, these flowers. Today, I went through my stash, and I remembered I had these. These are a tool that I ordered from... I can't think of it, but it's the ones who did Polymer Clay Adventure. And I have three different sizes here, so I think I'm going to use these today. But these are the cookie cutters that I used yesterday. They're just the little set of different shapes. And I've had these guys, like, I have tons of different shapes. I think you can get, there's a good selection at Hobby Lobby, I think, had the better selection of the smaller ones. And then here's my leaf shape, so I'll probably use that today again. I like those two for leaves. I'll use this for the centers, so we'll see. But I used these for the petals, so I just made five petals, and then I put that down. The orange one is five petals, the blue is five different shaped petals, and I have a bunch of gems. These are what are these called? I kept the package. Got these from Glamour Glitz Hot Fix Crystals. I got these, I'm pretty sure, at Hobby Lobby. And so I'm embedding those in the clay. I had these millifloor glass, and I got these at Hobby Lobby. And then I embedded, these are like little spacer beads. They're just like silver metal. Because anything that's glass or metal won't burn when you put it in the oven. So I don't know where it's going to go today. So I'm sticking with this theme. I didn't antique this. Now, antiquing is when you take the clay and you cover it with paint and then wipe it away, and it'll stay in all the nooks and crannies like it did here. And sometimes I like it and sometimes I don't. And when it comes to bright color like this, I tend to shy away from it. So we'll see what happens today. So the first thing we've done is we've covered, you know what, let me go ahead and just cover the bottom. I'll do that with you guys on camera. And like I said, I have an 8 setting on my pasta machine. And I'm going to fold this up because I want it a little bit wider. There we go, that should do it, I think. And I'm just going to sit this. Actually, you know what? I'll turn this over. Just want to make sure. Yeah. And lay it on top. Did I reach? Yes. And I'm going to use the right side of my blade and cut this away. I worked with my hand inside this votive yesterday, so just gently and carefully kind of bevel it. Try to just go along the clay that's already there. Just get this off here. So you see what I mean? Like, I'm basically, it's like connected already. If I just push down along the edge, smooth out those bubbles, forgot to do that. And then just gently And I say gently a lot because I have to remind myself, because I'm so rough. I'm cutting. You don't want to go too deep because you'll get a hole. But you can pretty much just cover it over with other clay. So don't panic. It's not the end of the world. And it's the bottom. You're not going to know. Well, you're not going to notice this as much once we purdy it up. All right. So it's a big thumbprint. So yeah, it's very warm here in New Jersey today. It's humid. I took the dog for a walk and I was sweating. I don't want to be sweating in February. Well, it's actually March today. March 1st. Time flies. So see, I'm just gently taking that excess clay off, and I think we're good. Then I'll just shape it with my fingers, just grab and push and make sure it's all, the seams are all, oops, see that came apart. It kind of works better when you pinch, so pinch it together. That's a better way to go. And I put a lip around it with gold clay on my other one. So who knows? I'll cover this up. It won't be an issue. All right, so that's how I covered my votive. And this is, like I said, this is called wisteria. You can use any color background you want. I mean, I think it would look pretty on a black background. It would probably look amazing. And I may do another one because I went and bought four of these today at my Dollar Tree. My Dollar Tree has the shape, and I love the shape because it's not like, you know, if you're just using a candle in it, you don't mind if it's a little tippy on the bottom. Like, I mean, more narrow on the bottom, but this is nice and it's kind of straight down. That's why I really liked it for a pencil holder. So we're gonna get started, guys. I think that is ready to go. Do I want to do some background stamping? I think I do. I really like the look of the script. I really liked, and I have some hearts, I have some swirls, I have music. Let's see. What do I want to do? I think music is another excellent way to go. So this is different from yesterday. And for clay, I think the smaller the pattern, the better. So that's why I'm looking for some small-ish. These swirls are pretty good. I like them. But I'm going to go around and put a few words on here. Well, it's not really words, it's just the image of script writing. And some of it, oop, that looks like a bubble. No, it's not a bubble. It was a dent. I just got a hair stuck in there. Okay. And I don't know what this says. It could be French or English or whatever. So there's a few of those. Maybe some music. Because it's a rounded surface. It's a little interesting. You have to kind of roll it. But I think I'm going to try it. Yeah, that worked. It was crooked. And, you know, I'm probably going to cover most of this up. I'll put a few hearts. Because who doesn't love hearts? I love hearts. And they're really showing up nice. Because I'm pushing hard. All right. So that's cool. I kind of like that. I didn't do it to this one yesterday at all. It's just flat in the background. Well, it's an option. And I didn't use any swirls, so I'm good. Let me put these back. Try and keep my desk as clear as I can. All right, so I'm going to start making some flowers. And that's it. You just start, and I started with the biggest, and I went to the smallest, because you can always fill in at the end. I'm going to use this big flower. And I think I'm going to start with yellow today. I didn't do any yellow flowers, and I think I want to do yellow. And I'm doing all of this in a fairly small, you can use a roller. I have a pasta machine, and I use that. So I'm using the same setting, the number 8. On my pasta machine, that's a pretty thin setting, but on yours, it might be big. So just use what you have. And these are kind of cool because they cut, but you can also push this plunger, and it, I'll show you. Well, let's see. I haven't used them very often. It makes that pattern in it. So let's do a couple. Cut, plunge. Oops. I don't know if I'm doing it right, but I like it. See, it's about the same size as that orange one. That's why I figured these three sizes would be good. I'm going to put this all the way up high, and I'm going to cut that off, and then we'll go medium. That's it. I'm just sticking it down just like that, giving a little, some decent pressure. Let's do another one. You can, sometimes they get stuck to the tile. So I am going to release it with my my knife. Let's do one kind of hanging off the bottom over here. So I'm going to push it into that little well area. And I'll cut it right here. So I just take my blade. I'll go this way. Oops. And I'll cut this one too while I'm at it. And then we'll do a couple more. So on the other one, I only did like 3 orange. And then I ended up going back and putting just a few off the edge and stuff. So that's why today I just felt more, I was really figuring it out as I went yesterday. So this today is a little more like I know where I'm going with the design. So it's a little faster for me to work and show you guys. So let's see, I think I'm going to put this one right here. I think one more at least. One. I love yellow and purple. Oops, I forgot to push down. Oh, damn. It's all right. Let's try and get one over here. I forgot to use the plunger on this one. Let's see if I can do it. Put it back in. Yeah, I got it. I think it's starting to rain. I think it was calling for rain. So here maybe. I like that. And feels like I need to have something right up here, like a part of one again. Like right there. Hanging over. Now the ones I did yesterday, because I used petals, I had to add a center. Now these, I think I will, but I may just add a gem. I think I'm just going to stick a gem in the middle of that. I mean, I think it looks good without, because it has this. I think that's like the perfect little space. for a gem. So I think I want to move to, let's see, because I want to have room for leaves. Let me get the yellow off here so I don't get my clay all. All right, so let's go with the next lightest color. Do I want orange? I think I do. I really do. I think I want orange, and I think I want this light pink. This is like, I think this might be a Sculpey color clay. It's so soft. But I think I want orange. Maybe I should do a blue. So I have a couple different greens. These are scraps. So I have these scraps. I'm going to do a couple different greens for my leaves. What other colors? I did yellow. I have red. What does red look like on this? Red looks pretty good. Red didn't show up on that fuchsia yesterday as well. I like red. I think I'd rather do like a dark blue. Ah, I love this blue too. That's kind of light. See, if I could make decisions, how does the fuchsia look? Fuchsia looks pretty good too. But I think I'm going to do orange and pink. Let's go with this pink first. This is so sticky. So we'll see how it goes. Again, number 8. And, oops. Maybe only, so I'm going down a size. This is the first size I used. Now I'm going down a size, but it's the same shape flower, so it won't be as varied as yesterday's. But I had these. Like, that's what I'm saying, guys. I'm trying to use what I have, and I'm sounding like a broken record, I know. And you guys can cut them with an X-Acto knife. You don't need anything fancy. But, you know, I buy this stuff and I never use it. I think this is the first project I've ever done with these. Honestly. I mean, I may have cut a few out and maybe, I don't know, played around a little bit, but I'm excited that I'm using them. So let's see where I want to put these. Ooh. The edges are a little rough looking, so I'm just kind of pinching them before I put it on. Hopefully I'm zoomed in well enough for you to see what I'm doing. So it's raining. I love rain. I do. I mean, I like when it rains. I like the sound of it. As long as it's not storming and anybody's getting hurt. So I'm going to put one down here. These are so sticky. I'm going to put one here. See, they're kind of close to each other. And do I need another one? I probably should put one hanging off the side too. I think I'll put one hanging over the edge. Got that sunshine in my pocket. Did you guys see Justin Timberlake? Oh, I forgot to plunge it. Open the Oscars. It was so good. I love him. He's so talented. Anyway, that song's been stuck in my head. And I heard music today, but that song just stuck in my head. I'm gonna put this right here. Just push it down so it's connected. I'm gonna put one, like, a little piece up there, I think. See, this is where it gets a little interesting for me because, ooh, I could probably use this piece. Let me see. Like, why not, right? So sticky. I think that'll be good. Just want to even it with the top. It's good enough. And we'll go to the next size. What color should I use? This is the trickiest part. I did that. I don't think I want to go, I think I want to go dark. I'm going to go red. I like red. And you know what? This is like a glittery red too. And these are all, yeah, I was working with these yesterday, so they've been conditioned. But you got to get your clay a little conditioned before you, ooh, it's coming down. When you put it in your pasta machine, you'll break your pasta machine if you don't condition it. I've done that. Makes your rollers wonky. So, all right, and then I'm going to go to my littlest one and see what that looks like. Oops, so plunge it out. See if I like it on there. Oh, I think I do. I think I do. So this is super simple. Using this tool takes all the work out of it, really. I'm cranking out flowers. Yesterday I had to like place each petal. So this is definitely worth it if you're gonna, you know, like I can make votives very quickly now. I'm gonna put one up here. All you have to do is just kind of make sure your edges are clean looking. Like, that's all. I don't like when they look. I'm gonna put one right here. Now, what color centers should I use? Like, I have so many colors. Yesterday I used three different colors. Let's see. I think I'm gonna put that there. It's coming together. Oop, look, there's a little piece of. See, and if you get stuff on the bottom, I'll put my name on the bottom. I'm gonna try and see out there's bubbles. I'll get them out at the end. So let's see, how's that looking? I should have gone up. I think I'm going to take this one off and go up here. Because I had one there. And maybe a little piece of one on the bottom. Whole one. I'm gonna do one more color. I really like these though. And the thing is, I gotta save room for leaves, so I think I'm gonna stop. I've done those three sizes. We gotta add a few leaves and make sure we have room. And I wanna put centers. So let's see. Look at all these colors. Yellow, red, blue, green, purple. And then these are more of light blue, pink, clear. And this is like a really dark purple. Do I want to put the same color center, you know? And so on this one, I put clear in these little purples, which I love them. I might do that again. I put the red in the blue and the blue in the red. I put Milliflora in the big oranges, which I don't want to do that again. And then I use the same color in here, the light blue in the light blue. So what do I want to do? I think I want to put purple in the yellow. Listen, I'm just going for it. I'm going to just squeeze these out. This is kind of a dark purple color. Maybe it won't show up, but I like it. I'm going to do it. And I'm just going to put it right in the center and push. And it embeds itself. Now, yesterday I had one gem. One gem fell off that after it was baked, and I just glued it back in. But for the most part, they embed themselves. Like, if I push it into the clay, there's a quarter inch of clay there. These are hot fix too, but which I thought if I heated them up, like in the oven, that it would actually adhere. You know, it would be smart probably if you have Bacon Bond, put a little dab of it behind there, and then it would totally bond it, you know, but I'm just lazy and I forgot to get it today. I have Bacon Bond, but it's old and I just think it's like super sticky and weird. But look, I mean, that looks so pretty already. I love adding gems. So this is fun, you guys. It's super simple. It's a useful item. So what color do I want to put in the pink? I guess pink, right? Maybe I'll put pink in the pink and put red in the red. Maybe I'll stick with the color that, well, no, because I just put purple in the yellow. That doesn't make sense, does it? Push it down. So let's see. I have one on the edge. I think I can fit one right here on the tippy top. It might stick out a little. But I think I'm going to go for it. I might have to, I'm just going to push it down to kind of make sure it stays adhered. It looks a little funky, but I like it. All right, so those are all done. This fluorescent pink, maybe it would look better with a darker color, like a blue. Red and red. I think I want to put the red and red. I'm running out of them. Okay, so this is red. Actually, I could go smaller on the red. So I may use different gems. I'm going to hold off on them because it's getting smaller. I think I can go this size on the other one. So I'm going to do on the pink. Maybe this pink. Let me see what it looks like. I haven't opened this one yet, have I? I just cut one slit. Here I made a triangle, but this I just cut one slit and then you can kind of squeeze it out. Because otherwise it'll be all over the place. So let's see what that looks like. It kind of looks purple. I don't know. Oh man. Why can't I make decisions? It's just not my thing to make decisions. I kind of want to put the red in the red, and then I'm going to come back with something else. Let's see what this would look like. I'm just playing now, guys, because I don't know. That kind of looks cool. See, I just put them by themselves, which I might do that again as a filler. I have these other size gems. I'm just going to come over here. These are by Tulip. And then I have this size, which I think these are Swarovski. And these are on clearance. So I always get them because they're very expensive. So this seems a little small. There's some bigger ones here. I think these are the heat set too. What color? So there's brown and blue. They're tiny. These are like, I think they're red. All right. I know I'm just taking up a lot of time, but there's like a gold in here. I think I might put, oh, why can't I make decisions? Kind of orange, pink and orange. I'm gonna do the orange. I like pink and orange. Sorry. It just came to me. So I have to find a couple of oranges. Of course, okay, there we go. One, two, three. That's a little small. So there's three. Hopefully I have enough. Yep, four. Okay, I'm gonna put them in the pink. I think it's proportionate to the center. I will show you a close-up. But I like, oh man, this has a little ring around it, so I just made a ring around it. Damn it. It's alright. It'll be alright. So I won't do that. I'll just use my finger. And push that in. But you can absolutely see, look, let me come to another pink one. The center Let me zoom in. The center circle is the same size as that little gem. So I'm just pushing it in. I could actually put little something in those. I might do that on the big ones. I'm going to put little seed beads in there. So that I'll come back and do that at the end. I'll have to gather those supplies up. But there's little, like these little dots. I'm going to put seed beads in there. That's what I'm going to do. So see, every time I do something, I make it new, because I don't know, when I repeat stuff, it's not as fun. So these kind of are red. I think I might use these little ones for the red flower too. What other color? Red and what? See, it won't even show up. These are kind of red, but they're like, they have a Aurora Borealis or something. So I need that size, not the super big. So there's three. How many do I need? Here's one. Four. Let's see how many. I probably did more red than that, but I'm going to do it. And you can tell it's like this, the right perfect size. But I don't have something that I can, well, I'll maybe use this, and then if I slip off, I'm going to crash. And this is flat. I could probably use this. I'm just going to use my finger. I squish it a little bit. It's not a biggie. Because I can reinforce the lines with the stylus, or I mean my pointy tool. But this is the best for me. I love bling. And like I said, if this falls out, I will glue them in at the end. But I'm going to bake this with the gems in it, because if they're glass, it you can bake it with it. Oh, one more here, and I'm just using my finger. There's pink right here. I can put one in there. See the purple. Oh, no. What did I use for pink? Orange, this. Yeah, they're a little wonky, some of them, but that's okay. It'll still flicker. So I think I'm good with all my gems. All right, so I'll clean this up. I'll be right back. All right, I'm pretty happy. I'm on to something else now. Yesterday, I added my leaves, and then I put a little stem that connected them. It was such a pain in the butt. I mean, it wasn't that big of a pain in the butt, but it was a little bit of a pain in the butt. So today, I'm going to try something different, and I wanted to add what I call swirlies, right? You know how I do my little swirlies. So I'm going to attempt a swirly, right? See, this is too long. Let me cut it, and it's hard to do because I have to hold this. But I'm going to, I don't like the tip of that. Hold on. Fix it. All right. So I'm going to just get that set down. Like you have to put it in. All right. I don't want to go too far. I always forget. All right. And then I'm going to go, oops. Hold on. Got to try and make it pleasing to the eye, right? And I guess that's as big as I'm going to go. Oh, damn it. Because I like to make them like that. Like, that's kind of cute, right? And then, so I'm not going to really push down hard on this because I want to see what it looks like first. Where's my cutting thing? I just had it. This. So I'm just going to put that there for a sec. And then on these pink flowers, I'm going to use this color. And I like this color, this shape. I'm going to use the dark. And maybe two leaves, right? And what I like to do is put it like this. So the leaf is coming off of that, sort of kind of, right? That's the stem for it, and it's a swirly to boot. So I kind of like that. But you can still attach it, which it's just a pain to use this little piece of clay as it's like, you don't need it. You know, it's fantasy, right? And then you take the little, I have a needle tool, and then I make these vein lines. So what do you think of that? Does that look cute? I think it looks cute. So I'll do that on the pink ones. I'm gonna make a swirl with a thing. And then for my bigger leaves, I like this light color a lot. And you could do a vein line, or a stem, I guess it's called, right? So look, these are so gorge. But does it really need a stem? I don't know. Usually things have stems, you know? That's what I'm thinking. But you could do two like that. And then stems. Does it need stems? Gosh, I don't know. All right, I'm just gonna try and do it with a stem real quick and see. It's just a pain in the butt to roll out these little stems, but you know what? It makes a difference and it, see, because I'm so rough, I kind of, all right, I have to start again. Gently, I have to tell myself to be gentle. And I'm gonna cut this little end so that it's flat and see what happens. Put this on the end. And, you know, like maybe I should put that down first and put the leaf on top of it and it wouldn't be such a pain, but it's still a pain. I like it with the stem, so I'm just gonna make stems. So I won't do all of them on camera, but basically I just butt a little piece of clay up against it and stick it there. Like that, and then it has a stem. And you can move it over and make it a little more, okay. Yeah, I think it's, you gotta go with stems, right? All right, and then, like I said, I use my pointy tool here, and I make a vein line and some little, and I'm not holding my hand in the right, there, this will probably work better. I like to pull towards me when I do line work, even when I'm painting. It's just, I get a better result. And on these, I'm not gonna do it, but that's what I'm going for. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. All right, so I am going to probably put like two of these on each yellow flower. And I mean, it depends, because if it's too crowded over there, you know, I mean, if it's too crowded, I won't. But let's see how it looks. Because I did the pink going that way. It looks like an air hole, an air bubble right there. I should probably give him a leaf here. Like right there. And here. And then this one I'll go up this way, to kind of keep the green away from the green. And then I could do, see, this one already has one. I gotta do a swirl there, so maybe I put a green over here. Sorry, I'm gonna do a swirl here. So I'm just trying to figure out my spacing. Swirl there, because the pink needs a swirl. This guy needs that. Now see, I can't really fit necessarily. I'm gonna do swirl there, and this one needs a swirl too. But I could swirl down here on this one and put a leaf. And I can swirl this way. All right, I like that idea. I like that idea. I can swirl here And here. Nope. I am not going to swirl there. I'm going to swirl here. So these are both getting one because there's going to be a swirl there. So yeah, that's just, look, this is just going to be coming together. I'm not going to have that much filler on this one as I did the other one. And it's not going to look as chaotic. Like, this just looks a little chaotic to me. I love it because it has bling. All right. So I am going to do some more swirls. And I just have to roll this out gently because I push so hard and I start to break it apart. And that's not what you want. You want it nice. So where was I going to put a swirl? Over here. And I don't really know which way to go with my swirl. Aha! Oh, sorry. I was leaning back. So look, I can make a really big swirl on this one. Just because of the angle that I put it down. But where's my leaf? And I call leaves feathers a lot. If I say feather, you know I mean leaf. But I always call leaf feather and feather leaf. That's kind of a big swirly, but I like it. And then you little guy are gonna go right here. Look at that. Ugh, my hand is stuck. I kinda wanna make sure it adheres. And then just go boom. And I could connect it, but I'm not gonna. So I got a swirl there. I have to put a swirl. That needs a swirl. That has a swirl. See, there's nothing here, so that's gonna need a filler. Because I put the swirls going in the same direction. There's gonna be a pink swirl here. But yeah, see how I totally changed it up. Both of these votives, very similar theme, you know, it's just flowers basically. And I mean, if I had a butterfly, oh my gosh, would I love to put butterflies all over these. I need a butterfly. If you had a butterfly plunger set, so cute, right? Wouldn't it be cute? It would. I'm thinking of getting a dragonfly tattoo. I've been thinking about it. I want to make this big, so I'm going to start it over here. And go. Something like that. Push it down. And, that pink clay is so soft. I totally just smooshed. I touched it with my blade and it got smooshed. So I'll have to, I can re, I can't really re-plunger it, but I can re, oops. It's so soft and I'm so rough. So I'm just going to put little lines. Like that. Alright, so put that there, and then I need a green leaf. And you can change the shape of these. Like, I might pinch the tip a little and turn it. And that way it makes it look a little more flowy. Do I want to put it this way? Yes, I do. See how I just pinched the tip and turned it a little? And then, like that. Do, 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 do. I could put, oh, see, I could probably do a swirly on both sides of them. This has that. Where else do I need a swirly? That one has one. That one has one. This one needs one. And sometimes, I'm not the best swirly maker because my rolls of clay are not the same width. I have thick, thin, And I'm so rough, so let's say I'm gonna put it wherever, like right here, and just start swirling. Do I? I don't know. I think I'm going the wrong way. I think it stopped raining already. There we go. Sorry. Takes me a while to get my swirlies looking how I want them. So I just want even spacage on the top. And I don't want to hold it because push it down. So I just keep putting my hand in it. That's the way I'm gonna have the least damage. Oops, this is so sticky. Good. And then I need another leaf. And I think I'll pinch it a little. Which way do I want this one to point? I don't know. Same way, I guess. Like right there. And then go like this. Cute, right? See, I don't want to do them yet because I don't know if that's staying in that position. This, I think I want it to go a little more this way. And then this one can go a little more this way. I don't know why. This one's gonna stay here. But see how I pulled away? Oh, that was Joe. That looks so pretty. All right. Stop doing that. I'm much better at pulling it toward me for some reason. I feel like I have better control over this little pointy tool. But that looks so pretty. And that's what tempts me to possibly want to antique it and like all this stuff. But it will take away so much from the brightness, in my opinion. Now, I could maybe just not use black. And I could really, really, really thin it down and see what happens. But I know me, and I'm heavy-handed, and, you know, I would put too much paint, and then it would be too late. And you do that after you bake anyway, so I have time. But look at how beautiful. I love all that color. Oh, I'm still zoomed in. That's why I don't like zooming. So what else do I want to add more color. So I want to add a couple different colors. I have to figure out in what form I want to do that. What form do I want that color to take? So let me zoom back up or out, whatever I'm trying to do here. Okay. So let's see what I have. I have some air bubbles down here, but all right. I have to add stems. I know that. I think I need a blue. I'm going to use a dark blue. And I think I'm going to do the littlest flower shape, this guy. I really liked that. Oy vey, let me just... I'll be right back. Okay, so I got some beads out. I put all my stems on, and look, I've gotten some beads out. These are, I want to say seed beads, e-beads, I don't know what, like millimeter they are, you know, but I have this little container, and I just keep, I pulled the gold, I think I'm going to use gold, but I have these tiny ones, blue, silver, I think I'm going to use these in the pink flower, But I might just use gold on all of them. I haven't decided yet. So I just put out a few, and I've gone around, and I use a toothpick. Just a regular, these are from Target, I think. Diamond toothpicks. And basically, I'm going to do all the yellow ones with gold. So, I don't know how well you can see these yellow flowers on the camera view, but there's a little circle impression, and I'm going to put these in each area with the toothpick, just pushing down into the clay, and generally this will stay, and you know what, this will be my prototype, because this is for me, as far as I know. I'm not planning on selling it at the moment. You know how I hold on to all my babies. Just breaking off the tip. I just broke off the little tippiest tip because now I won't be able to get it. But I don't want to. I don't want that to make an impression. I just want the bead. The tip was sticking out of the end of the bead, and I just want it to. So see how I'm just putting it into, embedding it into each of those little dots. And you know what, guys? I think this looks pretty gorge. And I wouldn't have done this if I hadn't have used those, the cookie cutters. And I'm not sure that that's called a cookie cutter. Maybe if I can find the link to, that specific these things. These are like a plunger cookie cutter, so I have to figure out where I got them, and maybe I'll put the link in the description box for you guys if you're interested. And that's not to say you couldn't do this without it. You absolutely could. Just put little beads in little spots, and I mean, I've come back and take my needle tool and just impress that line a little deeper if I've lost some of them. But that's it. I've gone around each of the yellow flowers, and I'm gonna put these away, and I'm gonna get the pink ones. Actually, I can just kinda, I'm gonna do these pink ones, and I don't know what color they are, but these are glass. These are glass seed beads, but see how that's kind of like a, it's like a metallic-y, it's got purple and pink and orange on it, and they're tiny. So let me see, I think I want to put these on the pink. I could put gold though. I think I'm going to do it on the pink. And I can't wait to see what this is going to look like when it's baked. So I'm going to go around and just embed these beads into all my flowers. I'll probably do something in the red as well. I have yellow, no. I have silver, maybe I think I'm going to do gold. I have this little tiny blue. I don't know what I'm going to do, but I'll be right back. Okay, I think I'm getting to the end here, because I just have to stop. I don't know when to stop, but I ended up putting the little beads, the seed beads, in all the flowers, and that may be a little overwhelming. I don't know if I overdid it. I like it. Now I've cut some dark blue. These are just cookie cutters that have a flower shape. And I'm filling in, and I'm just going to fill in with some orange and dark blue, I think. So I'm just taking any, like, kind of big space that I see. I think I'll put one of each right here in that space. And there might not be a ton of space left, really. You know, but there was a big space there. I kind of like this has a spot there, and I think that might be it. I kind of want to make a little orange one. Oops. I love pink and orange together, so I think I'm going to put... That blue was there. Now I don't remember where I was going to put this. Up here. There's orange, though. No, it wasn't there. Here. Nope, there's orange already. There's orange right there. I mean, maybe I'm overdoing it. But I think... I definitely think I want to fill in just those couple of spots. Maybe a blue up here. Nope, I put a blue already. Maybe not even that shape. So anyway, this is the frustrating part for me now because I can't make decisions, but I think I'm going to keep it the smaller size. Whatever I do, it's just going to be this tiny one, and I'm going to put clear gems in them. So these clear ones here. Because I really loved how, let's see, these looked. These purple ones with the clear gem in it, they really just popped. And I don't think I'll use these this time because I did do stamping in the background. So I think I'm going to be done. I think I'm going to bake. I think I'm gonna make an orange little one right here. And maybe, did I put a blue? I think I'll put a blue up here. So just here and there, but I really don't, I think I'm getting a little carried away, you know? And I don't want to put too many. Can you even see what I'm doing? Alright, so I'm going to be done and I'm going to bake this. Now I'm going to bake it in my toaster oven. I have a toaster oven in the basement that is specifically for polymer clay. And Primo clay's 275 degrees and 30 minutes per quarter inch. So when you do this, so I've rolled these out pretty thin, right? So this is not, I think two of these may equal a quarter inch. So I think I'll bake it probably about 45 minutes at least. So, and it won't burn. I'm gonna tent this. It fits in my oven perfectly. And I'll put a piece of tin foil over it. I think I'll bake it upside down. I'm going to put my name. That's another thing I wanted to say. I have these little letter stamps, and I cannot find them, but I'm going to find them, and I'm going to stamp my name on the bottom. I just did it with a pokey tool yesterday, but I'm going to find my stamps and put the date and my name, and then I'll bake it, and I'll be back and share it, and I might antique it. Maybe I'll just use a dark purple or something. I'm not sure. All right, so let me clean this up and get it baked, and I'll be back. All right, it's all done. Here it is. And you know what? I don't know. I feel like I should have filled in more spaces. Like this one, see, that's the thing. You can't compare because each one has its own. Like, I think that I put too much yellow on here. I don't know. I like it. I love the blue in the blue. And I like all my beading, you know, all the beads in the nooks and crannies and stuff. Now I'm just debating if I should antique it because then it'll get into all the little nooks and crannies. I think I'm going to. You know what? We're going to try it on this one. I'm not going to do it on this one because this one just, it doesn't really have only the leaves. Well, it does have it. I don't know if I should or not. Anywho, I ended up putting all these white dots on the top and bottom, like to finish it off. And I don't know if I think I kind of liked the gold, just the gold strip. You know what? I have three more of these things. I'm going to make three more and I'm going to see which one I like. And I think I'll keep it to a minimum with the biggest one and maybe do more medium. I don't know what I'll do. More bright colors. Like maybe these colors are too pale. I don't know. This one definitely has a lot going on. Right? Cute though, right? So these are this is gonna be my brush holder. This one definitely, that's the one that I've been using. And maybe I'll put the other ones in this. I like this one though. I think I'm gonna use this one still. And maybe some of these will go on my Etsy store. All right, you guys. Thanks for watching.